He asked where the preachers were. I think they're busy parading around following a man. A man who didn't save them, a man who didn't shed blood for them, a man who's going to walk away from them one day. And then what are you going to have? It's time to start putting your trust back in Jesus Christ. The Bible says judgment begins in the house of God. And if it first begins with us, what will become of those who obey not the gospel? Where is the gospel amongst the Christians? It's all Trump. It's all America. It's all about patriotism and man-made things. We need to come back to God. You can't serve two masters. You can say that Trump is saved. You can say all of those things. And I voted for him. And I praise God that he did what he did in there. But ultimately, you've got to make a stand one day and say, who are you going to choose? As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Are you serving the Lord? When you idolize somebody over Jesus Christ, or you say he's not your idol, Trump's not your idol? Did you do this for Jesus Christ before Trump? 4 years ago, were any of you out on the streets for Jesus Christ? Jesus! Jesus! I see American flags. I see Donald Trump. Here's a Christian flag. Get used to it. This is what you should be parading around. Jesus Christ is the name above all other names. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. That's the name that has power and glory. But you want to take that glory and give it to somebody else. Somebody who didn't do anything for you. The swamp isn't drained. Hillary's not in prison. Illegal immigration, come on. Get with the program. God called you to be separate. Separate yourself from them. Why? Because of their leaven. They'll suck you in. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? What is it going to gain you to have Republicans in? We're not better off. Nobody's better off. The churches got shut down under Donald Trump. If that happened under Obama, you'd be saying he was the Antichrist. But here today, Donald Trump, trust the plan. Let me tell you something, there is no plan. But God has a plan. It's time to come back to him, America. Stop saying, oh, God bless America. You need to bless God, America. It's time for you to stop playing games. You're being judged, church. You did nothing with the freedoms that God gave you. The freedom of speech. You squandered it. In other countries, they go to prison. They're killed for doing this. But you didn't do this before Trump. And even now with Trump, where are you? I go to the abortion clinic. I might see one or two old Catholics. Nobody's out there for the little babies. Donald Trump says he's against abortion, but here we are. How many babies were murdered in the last 4 years under Donald Trump? He's not the answer. He never will be. You're looking forward to him in 4 more years. After that, he's going to run. You're going to vote for him. Stop with the foolishness. God is sick of it. He's calling you back out of the darkness that you've wandered back into. He left the 99 for the lost sheep. The elect need to come back before it's too late. Before he removes your candlestick, church. God is watching. He's looking for the churches, and he's going to come back. The Bible says he comes back to judge and to make war with the nations. But America, America, America. But what's going to happen when God judges America on that day? Take your stand today. If you stand with wickedness, listen, I love America. I'm a patriot, and most of you know me. I was out there on the front lines, battling Antifa, promoting America, standing up for the right to do this right now. But I'm here to tell you, you've wandered from the path of true freedom, true liberty that's found in Jesus Christ. That's why you're miserable. You had Donald Trump for 4 years, all the joy, the winning. It was fake. It wasn't real joy. That's why it's all gone now. And what are you left with? Where's your hope? It's so downtrodden Christians. You ought to have the joy of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I don't care who's president. Joe Biden doesn't dictate who I am, what I do, and my family. And he doesn't dictate you and your ability to go out and do what Jesus Christ told you to do. Go out and preach the gospel. Heal the sick. Lay hands on them. Cast out demons. Baptize in the name of Jesus Christ. You call yourself a Christian, you better get busy. Because God knows you. He's not mocked. He's not going to stand. Oh, you're going to stand before God one day and you're going to say, well, I rallied for Trump. It's not going to make any bit of difference. And neither is your church attendance record. It's time to get busy serving the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. It's time to exalt Jesus Christ. The Bible says to cast down all that exalts itself above the name of Jesus Christ. Today we're casting down your golden idol, Donald Trump. Moses up on the mountain with God, Aaron down with the people, worshiping the golden calf, distracting the people from the truth. The truth is what sets you free. And praise God that you got to hear the truth today. And praise God for every opportunity that every one of us will get to spread the truth. Make sure what you're doing out there today is spreading truth and serving the only one who can give hope, life, and that eternal life through Jesus Christ and Him alone.